Do you love to play video games? And are you thinking, you know what, it would be awesome if I could actually get a job making video games? Now, once you've thought that, your next questions probably are, firstly, should I start my own game studio? Should I get a job? And if it's a job, what kind of studio should I work for? Large studio, small studio, AAA studio? Also, you might be wondering about salaries. And last of all, you might be wondering, how can I actually get a job in the game industry? I'm Rahul Sehgal. I'm the founder of GameToMaker, and in this video, I am going to tell you a step-by-step process as to how you can get a job in the video game industry. And towards the end, I have something very, very special, which no one actually tells you, which is a kind of insider tip about getting into the game industry. So let's go. So the first question that comes to mind is, should I start my own game studio or should I actually get a job? And my recommendation to everyone I meet who wants to start off is to actually get a job, because if you get a job, you're actually going to get paid. And that way, when you're working, you can actually learn the process of making games. You can learn the business of games. You can learn a lot while doing a job if you're observant. And secondly, you can also get to meet people, you can build your network, and you can actually get a team together if you're doing a job. So even if you, whatever you want to do, if you want to start your own studio in the end, I definitely recommend getting a job first. One more thing, if you want to learn how you can design world-class games and find your fastest path into the game industry, I'm having a live event this Saturday, 27th of November, called GamerToMaker Nitro, and you should be there. Register for it. Link is in the description. Next up, let's talk about game jobs. And the one thing I want to say to everybody is that going to college and doing a course will not get you a game job. A degree or diploma or a PhD does not get you employment. You cannot walk into a game studio and say, here's my degree, diploma, PhD, and they'll give you a job. That's not how it works. How does it work? You have to show the person hiring you that you have some degree of understanding of the process of making games. That's it. Not your degree, not your diploma, not even your PhD. Doesn't matter if you go to some fancy college like DigiPen or whatever, it doesn't matter. You have to show that you know how to make games. So your next question is, how do you show that you know how to make games? And the answer to that is very, very simple. You need to be part of a game project. In GameToMaker, my first mantra is that the only way to learn how to make video games is to actually make them. You need to make game. You need to be part of a game project. Now, starting off, it's absolutely fine if you make these small games, which are, you know, you make from YouTube or Udemy, that's absolutely fine. But to have serious consideration for a job, you actually need to make a slightly more complex game project, and you need to do it in a team. Because remember, when someone interviews you, if they see a lot of solo projects, that tells them that you don't really like working with people, or you don't know how to work with people. So basically, when you're doing a job, you're going to be working in a team, and you have to show them that you know how to make games and you know how to make games in a team. That's really, really important. So you cannot avoid this step. It doesn't matter what college you go to. Basically, making your own game will teach you the fundamentals of game making. It will teach you the process, and it will teach you the mindset of game making. Now, I know you can actually do this at a game college. There are some colleges, there are some game courses which actually have a project. They actually have a game project integrated into the course. The GamerToMaker course is actually one of them. And once you've gone through that course, at the end, you will know how to make video games. You'll actually have a team. You'll actually have some experience, and you will have something really nice for your game project. And if you're actually interested in a course like this, do check out the GamerToMaker course. The link is in the description of this video. Also, if you are thinking of going abroad to study game development somewhere, then you definitely need to see this video which I have made on the topic of going abroad to study game development. All right, the next thing that is very, very important for you to do is to understand and decide on which role you want in game development. Now, there are three basic streams of roles. First is design, next is art, and then there is programming. However, even within these streams, there are lots and lots of specializations. For example, in 3D, you have animation, rigging, modeling, lots and lots of things, right? So before you actually apply for a job, it's quite important that you know what kind of role you want. Now, it's possible you might be confused. You might say, okay, how do I know which role is best for me? And once again, the only way to do that is to actually work on a game project. If you're working on a group project with several people, you can actually try these things out. You can do them. And once you've implemented it, once you've tried the role, then you will understand what you're good at and what you actually enjoy. So that's a great way of finding out what role is actually suited for you. Next up, you have to get these three things ready if you want a job: your portfolio, your resume, and your LinkedIn. Now, when it comes to portfolios, I have a video exactly for this, which is going to tell you about how you can make the perfect portfolio for a game job, and that video is right here. Next, resume and LinkedIn. Remember, your resume has to be focused for the job you want, which means that if you are applying for different companies, you probably have to tailor your resume for that, right? Your resume should have the heading of the job that you want, and do not forget to put clickable links to your portfolio inside your resume. Next up, LinkedIn. LinkedIn is absolutely everything. Very few people hire these days without actually visiting the LinkedIn page of the candidate. So I would say start working on your LinkedIn right now. Have a good profile picture. Have a nice cover photo, which is something from your game, some kind of artwork. Have a professional looking profile picture, you know, not something kind of unprofessional and weird. And also make sure that you put in links to the game you've made, that the work you've done. Start working on your LinkedIn profile right now. It is very, very important. Another very, very important thing to remember when it comes to the game industry and getting jobs is that almost all hirings, I would say 70 to 80% of hirings in the game industry, happen by recommendation. No one else finds out. Within the game company, they ask if someone knows someone, someone contacts their people in the game industry, their friends, their network, they send their resume and the hiring happens. You don't even see that job put out on the company website. So, which is why having a game industry network is absolutely vital. Once again, you might be thinking, I'm just starting off. How do I build a network? Well, for that, the best way to do it is to actually get out there and meet people. Game conferences are a great way to do that. IGDC happens every year. Attend it, whether it's virtual or it's an actual live event. Make sure you go to GDC. Also, volunteering for these conferences, volunteering for events is a great way. Try and be involved with the community. Try and give back the community. Try and work with people to build up the community. And that is also going to build up your network. Also, join some good servers. The Gamer to Maker Discord server is a great place to meet people who are like you, who want to get jobs, who want to join the game industry. So make sure that you're on the Gamer to Maker server. The link is in the description of this video. Next up, if you're wondering about what kind of salaries you can get as a beginner, as a starting point, and also how far you can go and how to actually get there, then you should probably watch this video, which is specifically on the topic of salaries in the game industry. All right, lastly, I'm going to tell you something really important, which no one tells you, which is that if you want to get a job and if you want to rise in the game industry, you have to build your personal brand. And that means you need to look like a professional. So remember that weird Instagram handle you have, that funny picture you have on social media. change it to something more professional, look like a professional, and you will be treated like a professional. So change your Instagram handles, be careful about what you post on the internet, about having fights with people. So build a professional reputation and start with your social media handles. Also on LinkedIn, like I said before, make sure you have a nice professional picture of yourself on all social media. Do not think that people are not going to find out about the stuff that you do on some social media like Facebook, etc. Remember, it's a small world. So make sure that your personal brand is that of a professional. It's something that you can be proud of, and it's something that somebody from HR or a potential boss or a potential employer looks at, that should not put them off. So remember that your personal brand is really, really important. All right, so that's all for this one. Thank you so much for watching. If there are any comments, do let me know. And if there's any other content that you want me to make videos on, that's awesome. Put it down in the comments. Thank you. I will see you on the Gamer to Make It Discord server. Let's go.